There are several amazing new features available in PowerPoint for Office 365. Here are the top 10. Number 1, 3D model animation. One of the coolest new features in PowerPoint for Office 365 is 3D models. Just go to the Insert tab, click on 3D models, and a list of several categories comes up on the screen. You can choose one of the categories like animals and select an image that you want to insert into your presentation. You can also search for models by name. Click the insert and it imports the image into PowerPoint. You can select from a number of preset views, or better yet, grab this control in the center and rotate the 3D model in the direction that you want. You can move it around the screen as any other graphics. You can also pan and zoom to select an area of the 3D model. There's one other feature about these images, and that is some of them are animated. So if you select from the All Animated Models category, any of these models that you select are full motion graphics. So I'm going to insert this bee. You can see here that it's full motion. And just like the other 3D models, you can rotate them, move them, and resize them as you want. You'll need to be cautious when using these models in your presentations because they take up a large amount of storage space. Many of these models are 25 meg or more. But if you want to spice up your PowerPoint presentation, use 3D models. Number 2, enhanced morph. There is a new morph option in the latest version of PowerPoint. Normally, morph provides a smooth transition from one slide to another for the same object. For example, let's say we have a rectangle. We copy and paste a new slide with the same rectangle, move it, resize it, and even rotate it. And now when we apply the transition morph, you can see that it moves from one location to the other and automatically resizes. It is a smooth morph transition. But what if we want to change a rectangle to a circle? So on the second slide, let's insert a circle and go back to the transitions and run preview. You can see that it fades out of the rectangle and then fades into the circle, but it doesn't do a smooth transition like we want with normal morphing. This is where the new selection naming feature comes in. Bring up the selection pane. You can do that in Windows by going to the Home tab. In the drawing group under Arrange, click on Selection pane. You'll notice that the selection is oval 1, and on this page, it's rectangle 3. If you double click on that, we can name this something else, but the key with this solution is you have to start with 2 exclamation points. So I'm going to just call it shape with the 2 exclamation points. And you want to do the same thing with the same name in the second slide. Now when you look at the transition morphing, it does a smooth transition from the rectangle to the circle. And that's how you use enhanced morph. Number 3, draw and ruler. There is a new menu tab in PowerPoint called Draw. It includes drawing pins, highlighters, and a ruler. If this tab is missing from your menu, just right-click on the ribbon in an empty area, choose Customize the ribbon, and make sure you've checked the box for Draw in the right column. Hit OK. And you should have the Draw tab on your menu. Select a pin from the menu, and you can freehand draw. You can add additional pins, change the thickness, change the color, and even add some effects. And when you select that, it will use that as your drawing. There is an eraser that allows you to erase an entire section or small, medium, or segment erasing. One of the coolest features of all is the ruler. which brings up a ruler on the screen and allows you to use the wheel on your mouse to adjust the angle. You can move it around the screen, and when you select a pin, you can actually draw a line using the ruler. To turn the ruler off, just click the button again, and you're left with your straight edges. You can also hit the ink replay, which reproduces the drawing in the order that you created it. Use the lasso selection to draw around the object, and it will select it so that you can now move it around, resize it. One key thing to remember is if you want to get out of drawing mode, make sure you hit the escape key. You can even select individual objects and delete them. And highlight an entire word and use the ink to text option. Let's grab a pen and draw a circle. And lasso that and do ink to shape. It converts it to a perfect circle. Altogether, the draw tool adds a whole new set of features to the latest version of PowerPoint. Number 4, Presenter Coach. If you want some assistance with your presentation skills, use the Presenter Coach. Presenter Coach is only available in the web version of PowerPoint for Office 365. Under Slideshow, go to Rehearse with Coach. It opens up your PowerPoint slide with a window in the corner for Welcome to PowerPoint Presenter Coach. Click the button to start rehearsing and start talking as if you're presenting your PowerPoint presentation. You'll get immediate feedback if you say filler words like or use non-inclusive words like fireman. It even warns you if you are mindlessly reading your slide. When you're done, stop the recording. It provides a rehearsal summary with recommendations, your presentation pace over time, and links to learn more about each suggestion. It's a helpful tool to improve your presentation. Number 5, Zoom. Zoom gives you the ability to jump to and from specific slides in your presentation. There are 3 Zoom types. The first is the summary Zoom. Go to the Insert tab, select Zoom, and here are the 3 choices. We're going to choose Summary Zoom, and it brings up a list of slides in your presentation. Select the ones that you want to zoom in and out of, and hit Insert. It creates a summary page, and you can move and resize these and position them anywhere you want. Once you have the page set, view your slideshow, and you'll see the Zoom in action. It shows the slides that we selected. When you click on one, it zooms into that slide. Hit the arrow key, it goes to the next page, and then when it's done with that, it comes back to the zoom. Now I can select another one and zoom in. You can move around any way you want within the zoom summary. The second type of zoom is the section zoom. It zooms in and out from sections in your presentation. You can add, delete, and rename sections in the slide pane on the left. To create a section zoom, go to the Insert tab, click on Zoom, Section Zoom, and it brings up all the sections in your presentation. Select the ones that you want, hit Insert, and now you can manually adjust each one of these and position them where you want on the page. When you bring up the slideshow, it brings up your slide presentation in sections. You can click on one, it zooms in, continues through that section, and then returns back to the main page. The third type of zoom is the slide zoom. It works the same as the section zoom, but lets you select from all slides in your presentation. It allows you to reposition them anywhere in the slide. Another item worth mentioning is when you click on a slide, you have a zoom menu option. It allows you to control those slides. You can choose to return to Zoom after you're done with that slide by checking this box. You can change the alignment, you can adjust the borders, and have Zoom effects with preset shadowing, reflections, glowing, bevels. So if you want to spice up your presentation, make sure to use one of the three Zoom options. Number 6, scalable vector graphics. One of the latest improvements to PowerPoint is the ability to import scalable vector graphics. Images with an SVG extension like this PowerPoint logo are scalable. No matter what size you make them, the resolution clarity is maintained because the image is made up of vectors and not pixels. This also results in smaller file size for your presentations. SVG images can be edited, so you can change the color. You can change the transparency and make artistic effects. All this can be done under the Picture Format tab that comes up when you have an SVG image in your slide. If you go to the Insert tab and you choose Icons, you can select from a variety of icons in SVG format, which makes these scalable as well. So if you want the best quality images in your PowerPoint presentations, use scalable vector graphic images as much as possible. Number 7, HD video export. The latest version of PowerPoint for Office 365 includes the ability to export your presentation as an HD quality video. Just go to File, Export, and select Create a Video. It gives you four different resolutions to choose from: Standard, HD, Full HD, and Ultra HD. You can also use your pre-recorded timings and narration, or record them right now. It lets you walk through the presentation. You can record, stop, and replay as if you're presenting your PowerPoint presentation. You can record audio and video, and change the color of the slides in the process. You can also see your notes, and when you're done, close the window. It returns back to your export where you can create your video. If you don't want to use the pre-recorded timings and narration, just select a time that you want to spend on each slide and create your video. The HD video export is a great option if you want to pre-record all of your presentation instead of doing it live. And with the added high resolution options, it makes it much crisper looking for your audience. Number 8. Dictate and Translate. Dictate and Translate are two new additions to PowerPoint. Let's insert a text box on this slide, position it, resize it, and double-click inside the box. Now, from the Home tab, select Dictate, and it records your message. This is a test of PowerPoint dictation. Turn it off, and it inserts the text into your slide. You can now edit and move the text box just as if you typed it in. Translate is available from the Review tab. Highlight text, click on Translate, and it detects the current language and lets you choose from a variety of different languages to convert it to. Click the Insert and it replaces the text with a new language. Click on the double arrow to reverse the translation, and you can insert it back to the original language. You can choose your default language for proofreading, and also set your language preferences for all of your buttons, menus, and other controls. Dictate and Translate are two great new features that help you speed up creating your presentations and helps manage them in different languages. Number 9, Design Ideas. Design Ideas has been available in PowerPoint since 2019, but Microsoft continues to improve the artificial intelligence it uses to determine different design ideas. From the Home tab, select Design Ideas, and it generates a variety of different choices for layouts in your slides. PowerPoint will use your slide template to make design suggestions, and it even incorporates online images into those designs. It will even use the subject of your text to make decisions. select the layout, and it replaces your slide. Design Ideas is the simplest and best tool to make your presentations look professional, and it's only one click from the menu. Now it's even better with the new intelligence built in. Number 10, reuse slides. You can add slides to your presentation from another without having to open the other file. Just select the Reuse Slides from the Home tab. It shows a list of recent PowerPoint files. Click on one and select each slide that you want to insert into your presentation. You can position the location where you want the slides inserted in the left pane. Also, at the top, you can uncheck this Use Source Formatting. If you want to insert a slide, it will convert the slide into the format of the slide above your insertion point. With Office 365, you will also see recent PowerPoint slides that have been shared with you from other team members as well. This feature makes it easy to collaborate on team presentations. So save yourself a bunch of time with the Reuse Slides feature. Hey, if you want to see more videos like this one, please subscribe. And if you've enjoyed this video, be sure to click the thumbs up and leave a comment. I really do appreciate your support.